War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. Never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right. Hey, hon.
I'll just be a minute.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
You see, Jimmy, our government has bullies too.
More of the same.
Which is why we've developed some whiz-bang new weapons, so bullies around the world never bother us again.
Nuka-Cola. Ice cold.
Oh, sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Shaw.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
But then we're looking at a cold front coming down from Canada.
Hey, hon.
Crisp and dry for
next week's
Halloween.
Wow, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
Next week's forecast, we have a high of 52 on Monday. But also appear our troops stationed overseas are experiencing some unusual weather as well. On the island of Mombacham.
Good old USA.
Cold, unseasonably so for Southeast Asia.
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Something that is unquestionably, inescapably American. I am referring, of course, to our great national pastime, baseball. This afternoon, right here in the city.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Led by star pitcher
hello?
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection he's so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on. How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions. We're, trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir, the news...
We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh, my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
The nukes are coming! Those communist bastards!
This way! All vault participants!
Thank you.
residents of Sanctuary Hills. If you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Vault participants, this way!
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female.
Okay, go ahead. Thank you.
Good luck, ma'am. And God help us all.
Get to the vault!
You two, follow me! Come on!
What's gonna happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can! Now keep moving! Step on the platform! In the center!
This way!
All right, that's it! Send it down!
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
Hey,
no
there.
Need to worry, folks.
What?
You all right?
We'll get everyone situated
okay,
in your new
please?
Home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
Vault Tech is here for you.
Minute,
Liz, all new residents.
No, please, don't get caught up.
Nope.
Email and
this good.
Step over to the table and take a seat. Just step over to the table.
Thanks.
Welcome.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See?
This
way,
it's gone. Our home.
Our home.
Everything
sir?
We have.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
Hey,
this
move
is
along.
One of our most advanced
God,
facilities.
Honey. What if they didn't
Not
make it?
Not that the others aren't great,
I
mind
know
you.
This is a difficult time.
How long do you think we'll be down here? With you
every oh, we'll be way. Going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
It's a good fit.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic.
Okay.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise. Giant roaches? What the hell? Nice. Coming back later for you.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
Hey there.
Please. I'm so thirsty. Could you spare any water?
What kind of water did you need?
Purified would be wonderful. But anything you have would do.
Wish I could help, but I don't have any.
If you do find some, don't forget about me.
What the?
Thank you.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
You lose your owner, buddy.
Okay, then. Let's stick together. Out of bobby pins. I'm through. No bobby pins. To the world.
The world, sir? Well, besides our geranium still being the envy of Sanctuary Hills, I'm afraid things have been dreadfully dull around here.
Things will be so much more exciting with you and Mrs. Beck.
Where is your better half, by the by?
She's in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Codsworth, listen to me carefully. Have you seen him? Have you seen Sean?
Why, the missus had him last, remember? Or perhaps she's gone to the Parker residence to arrange a play date. I'm sure she'll be back with him momentarily.
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Two hundred years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little, for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're two centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were... dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir! What's all this, then? Found you! Ha! I trust everyone's still alive.
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir, your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
Come on, Codsworth. I need your help. Where can I go?
Well, you could head into the city. Concord is nearby. But the people there are as put together as I am.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station? I shall remain here and secure the home front.
Way I could pick this.
Hey. Over here.
Through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
Got it. coming in there, and they're gonna skin every last one of you!
Come on, man, they ain't going nowhere. We got other shit to deal with.
You hear that?
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvin, Commonwealth Minutemen.
God damn it.
Minutemen? So now I'm traveling backward in time?
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, wanted to make a difference. And I did, but...
Nope.
Things fell apart. Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
The world's changed so much. None of this makes sense.
You all right? Listen, we need your help. And then maybe we can help you, huh? What brought you out here?
My son Sean's been kidnapped. He's not even a year old.
That's messed up. I'm sorry. I know how this world can be. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. First, it was the ghouls in Lexington, and now this mess.
Ghouls? What are ghouls?
Wow. You really aren't from around here, are you? Ghouls are... irradiated people. Most are just like you and me. They look pretty messed up and live for a long time. But they're still just people. The ones I'm talking about are different. The radiations rotted their brains, made them feral. They'll rip you apart just as soon as look at you.
God damn it.
Anyway... we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But... well, we do have one idea.
One good idea can make all the difference.
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school. Pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
I like it.
Yeah, I thought you might. Protection with an added bonus. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Minigun. Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
I'll help if I can.
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find it.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
Actually, I already grabbed the fusion core. We're set.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
There we go.
We need help, folks. And you get a vault dweller? What are you going to do in that stupid jumpsuit? Bleed to death?
And it's angry.
Oh.
Up here. Boss! We got somebody up here!
Why don't you get down here? Show me that fancy gun up close.
Not a lot of people could get past my boys. I give you that.
You're awake, asshole!
Thank you.
You okay?
I'm fine, Preston. Quit fussing.
Hey.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
Feelings mutual, Preston.
You can never have too many friends. Not in the Commonwealth. Listen, when we first met, you asked about the Minutemen. One thing you should know about us, we help out our friends. So here, for everything you've done, thank you.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Well, since you say that, maybe you'll come to Sanctuary with us. We could use your help getting settled there.
All right, Garvey. I'm in.
Oh, that's wonderful. But there's more to your destiny, isn't there? I've seen it, and I know your pain.
Okay, I'm listening.
You're a man out of time, out of hope. But all's not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
I knew it. Please tell me where he is. I need to find my son.
I can't see him. Not clearly. But I feel his life force. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
What's in Diamond City? Is Sean there?
Look, kid, I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The site will paint a clearer picture.
No, Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk, it's gonna kill you.
Shush, Preston. We're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the site. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too. Now let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy saw it?
Oh, hold on.